If you have debilitating vertigo, it's important to know the cause so you can recover as quickly as possible. I'm Dr. AJ Ludlow, and in this video, you'll learn how to tell the difference between BPPV and vestibular neuritis. Make sure to watch until the end because we'll cover what to do to recover from each condition. First, we'll cover vestibular neuritis. This condition is caused when a virus causes damage to the vestibular nerve. It's possibly a form of the herpes virus, which also causes cold sores, chickenpox, and shingles, but has also been found to be associated with influenza, measles, rubella, mumps, polio, hepatitis, and the Epstein-Barr viruses. The vestibular nerve brings information to the brain from our inner ear to help us maintain balance. The infection causes inflammation and swelling of the nerve, which distorts the information coming into the brain and causes vertigo. About 50% of people with vestibular neuritis will have viral symptoms, kind of like a head cold, before the vertigo sets in. When vestibular neuritis starts, it's a sudden onset of dizziness, nausea, vomiting, and a feeling of being off balance that lasts for about 1 to 3 days. Over the course of a week, the dizziness will gradually decrease. Then over the next few months, the symptoms will continue to slowly decrease. It usually doesn't cause further intense episodes of dizziness after it starts to calm down, and it doesn't affect your hearing. During the first intense few days, the symptoms are constant, and the symptoms might be made worse by head movements, but they aren't triggered by head movements. BPPV stands for Benign Paroxysmal Positional Vertigo, which, as the name implies, is the feeling of spinning that comes on suddenly from certain head positions. It's called benign because it's not life-threatening or progressive, even though it is intense and debilitating. It's caused when particles in the inner ear called otoconia come loose and enter one of the inner ear canals. This is a fluid-filled canal that helps our brain process head movement, and when the particles move inside the canal, they cause a false sensation of spinning. Vertigo attacks from BPPV are a sudden, intense feeling of spinning that only lasts for about 30 to 90 seconds. It can cause nausea and vomiting during the attack, but afterwards it'll settle down and you'll feel fine until another attack is triggered. BPPV attacks are only triggered by specific head movements that cause the particles in the inner ear to move. These include getting into and out of bed, rolling over in bed, and looking up or down. Comparing the two conditions, we can find some key differences to help you know which condition you have. They follow very different patterns. Vestibular neuritis comes on suddenly and intensely, with the most intense vertigo lasting constantly for a few days, then fades over weeks and months, and the vertigo is not triggered by head movements. BPPV has a sudden onset, but is triggered by head movements exclusively, but they only last for a minute or two and then will settle down and you'll be fine between these episodes. But the triggering head movements can cause another episode. Each episode is consistent and feels about the same. So based on this information, you should be able to tell the difference between the two. Now, what can you do to get rid of the vertigo? For vestibular neuritis, you are healing from a viral infection, so getting plenty of high quality sleep is very helpful. The symptoms generally fade on their own over the course of weeks or months, but a low inflammation diet can help, as well as high doses of vitamin C and other anti-inflammatory and immune boosting supplements. Some doctors will prescribe anti-dizziness medications or anti-nausea or steroids, but these medications have limited benefits and they all have side effects. Going to a physical therapist or for vestibular rehab or finding vestibular rehab exercises online can help recalibrate your balance more quickly. BPPV has a quick and easy solution. You can do a repositioning maneuver to clear the particles from the inner ear, which can immediately stop the spinning. You can go to an ENT or a physical therapist for this, or you can just do it at home. Click the link at the end of the video for a step-by-step guide on how to do the maneuver and how to keep BPPV from coming back.